الله تعالى وبركاته بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الفائزين برضا الله أما بعد Honorable Chairman and my dear friends, it's immense pleasure to be here in the Mahfile Twaiba 2K79. I would like to speak based on the topic spiritual Islam versus radical Islam. Dear friends, Islam is a religion of peace, world as Islam is a word derived from Arabic, which means peace. And this classification we see in the entire society, such as tribes, Muslim, Hindus, and Christians, is not to get scuffle each other and not to attack one another, but it is to get acquainted. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds to the Quran, chapter number 49, Al-Hujurat, verse number 13, that Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min al-dhakri wal-untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu. That, O humankind, we've created you from the man and the woman only to get acquainted, and you are being classified into tribes and race and all other countries only to get acquainted, only to know one another. So that was the intention behind the classification and not to attack each other. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches through the Quran about the Islamic conception, that وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَيُصُبُّ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us that we should not blame any other non-religious. Anyone who worships rather than Allah, because there is a chance that probably they would attack Allah back. So that's the harmonic, that's the message of the Islam sent towards all over the world. And we know that the word Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also teaches us to be mercy all over the creatures in the world. He says that irhamu man fil ardi wa yarhamukum man fis sama. You should be mercy towards all the creatures in the earth, that the creatures in the sky would be mercy towards you. That's a great sentence and the great message led by the Islam. But in contrast, we have to classify and we have to compare this Islam, the real Islam, to the radical Islam. The most terminology mystified in the recent 21st century is the jihad. So I would like to start with jihad. That the jihad, what does jihad mean? The Oxford Dictionary gives the two meanings for the jihad. First one is, it is a fight against the person himself from breaking the religious and moral rules. Second one, it is the holy war fought by Islam against the enemies to defend Islam, not to attack. Second. This is the jihad. This is what means jihad. But recently we know that the Jihadistic and the Chauvinist terror organizations, terror outfits such as IS, Al-Qaeda, Lashkar-e-Taiba, or in the name, they're emerging in the name of Islam, and they're just circulating the Islam is this, and they want to establish the Khalifa, that the imperialist powers are against him. Actually, it is a hidden agenda of the imperialist power, whereas we know that the Taliban is and it's emerge of all these terror organizations, which was started by the America itself, but now it became an effect. It has adversely affected America too. In this occasion, I would like to say that the Salafism is the main core point of this radical Islam, whereas the attack all of the symbols of Islam. We know about the recent attack of the tombs and shrines in Afghanistan, the Pakistan, and the shrines and the tombs are considered as the master symbol of the Islam. And the Salafis, they just attack all these tombs and they just also kill and they just lynch who follow the real path of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and who belongs to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jamaah. We know about the emergence of this Wahhabism from the Ibn Abdul Wahhab, from the who born on 1703, and he started his tribe would away by demolishing all of these shrines and all of these maqbaras and all of these tombs, and he also attacked, he also killed, he also massacred all of the Muslims who followed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's what the clear contrast we can see between Islam and the radical Islam. We know that we should be in the harmony towards all of other religions, irrespective of what from where they come. But But recently, unfortunately, a Salafist leader in Kasaragod had deliberated a speech asking Ogin that not to even gaze at the non-Muslim. So this is the message, the false message given by the Salafism and in the name of Islam. And that's why the Islam is being tainted and Islam is being criticized and Islam is being misunderstood all over the world. By saying this, I conclude my words. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.